Hello, everyone, and welcome to the show Excellence in All Things. I'm your host, Barbara Golar. I'm so excited to have in studio. This is a very, very special month. What I really like to do, I like to really showcase different themes and different awarenesses. And so for the month of June, it is Alzheimer and Brain Awareness Month. And so the wonderful people that I have in studio are going to share some information with you. And I'm going to tell you just a little bit because I'm really excited about this, because as you know, I'm a native Monrovian. And so Monrovia, which they'll be able to tell you more detail about what that entitles. And what it entails is that Monrovia was just named dementia-friendly community. So without any further ado, I'd like to introduce my wonderful guests here. And actually, you know, before I introduce them, I want you to get your family to come around to watch the show, because it's very important that you hear this. Okay, so without any further ado, I'd like to introduce my guests. Yay!
Thank you, Barbara.
You're welcome. And so this is, you know, Nathan
Kirschenbaum.
I was practicing this morning. I said, you know, I can say his name when I'm looking at it, you know?
It is long.
Yes, absolutely. It's very long. It's a long name.
Yes. Yeah. Well, thank you for having us.
You're welcome.
I'm Nathan Kirschenbaum. I'm actually with Senior Helpers. We're an in-home care company. And that's really kind of what started me down the road of working with individuals with dementia. I got involved with Monrovia Providers Group a number of years ago. And I'm actually currently serving as their public relations chair. Monrovia Providers Group has been serving this community for over 20 years.
Yeah.
And it was founded back in the late 90s by a group of individuals who really believed that the seniors in Monrovia deserve access to services and programming. They've always worked in concert, collaboration with the city and other community groups. And about a year ago, they went down the path of trying to figure out how to make dementia-friendly become part of Monrovia. So how do we make Monrovia a dementia-friendly city?
Yeah. I'm going to stop you for one quick second.
Of course.
I also want to introduce our other guests.
Absolutely.
And we have, because I just met her.
Yes, I'm Dr. Cheryl Flynn, and I am also a part of the dementia-friendly group. And I came to that through a friend who's local in this community, and because I have both a personal and a professional interest in supporting a dementia-friendly community.
Okay. Now, I have a question for you before we go on. Mm-hmm. Doctor, because I, you know, we didn't even talk off camera. Usually I do that. But we got caught up with our phone, like the phone off, and, you know, and all these kind of things. And so, but anyway, doctor, is that a medical doctor or?
I have a PhD in neuroscience, but I'm also a physical therapist. So I have a medical side training as well as
physical
an academic training. Yes.
Okay, then we have to talk.
Well, and part of my professional interest is that I started a company called Blue Marble Health, and we have a real focus on older adult and senior health, whether it's fall prevention or dementia or breathing impairments and things like that.
Okay.
So when a friend of mine heard about this group and said, Cheryl, I think it's a really great fit, you should join them.
It sounds like it's a good fit.
Yeah, yeah, and it's been a lot of fun. Being a part of the group so far.
Yeah, okay. I just didn't want the continuum without introducing our other guests.
Well, thank you for that, because it's hard to stop me from talking.
Yeah, so. I know. See, because, you know, he came in and spoke to the Interfaith Council of Monrovia.
Oh, nice.
You know, but it was wonderful.
Well, thank you.
It was really, really good.
Well, as you could tell, I'm very passionate about this project.
Yes.
So, a little bit of background, okay? So 1 in 10 seniors has dementia, and that's clarified as people 55 and over, okay? The population of seniors in LA County is going to double between now and 2030. That's 11 years. And potentially triple between now and 2050. So that means the number of people living with dementia are going to grow exponentially. So addressing this now, before it's a public health crisis, mm-hmm. and putting in place systems and programs to actually help not only these individuals, but the families that support them. So being a family caregiver could be a very daunting task, particularly when the individual that you're caring for has dementia, because as dementia progresses, because it is a progressive disease, mm-hmm. things will get more and more challenging, not only for the individual, but of course for the family member. And the other thing that's really important is the person that's impacted directly because they have the disease, it's not just them, it's the entire community that they're interconnected with. If they've already lived that many years in their community, they're probably connected with the church or a community group, mm-hmm. or the city or their business or whatever that is. Mm-hmm. And every person that has interacted with them over the years is going to be impacted by their inability to act like they used to.
Mm-hmm.
So a dementia-friendly community helps give us all tools to be a better dementia friend and to better support those individuals.
Mm-hmm. Well, I know, like, for instance, when you came and spoke to the Interfaith Council of Monrovia, I start thinking, you know, each of us in our own different faith traditions, I think that I thought then, and I'm thinking that as you were speaking, is that it would be also nice because it was just us that heard it. And then if we went back to our faith tradition, it's not the same as coming from you, the expert, you know. So I don't know, do you do things like going into different organizations and just speaking with their organization?
Well, yeah, absolutely. Well, one of the things that we've been doing to get the message out and find people that are interested in getting involved, mm-hmm. is going out and speaking and doing presentations. We actually have about 29 individuals that have participated in one level or another in our committee. Mm-hmm. Our committee meets every quarter now at the Monrovia Community Center. As a matter of fact, we're meeting today.
But you also, there's something else coming up on the 22nd. Is there something coming up on the 22nd?
Not that I'm aware of.
Okay, maybe there's so much going on
there
on
sure
the 22nd.
Is. Yes.
That
it's a very busy Saturday.
Saturday, yes. Mm-hmm. And because I'm thinking, and on all those things are things that I'm involved with.
Okay.
Indirectly. And I'm thinking, how can I get to all of those things?
Sure. Well,
I was just going to mention one of the things that we're going to be building up to is offering like a community training. So when you mentioned, could we come and talk to a specific organization? I think what we for sure can do is let the organization know when we're going to have a training.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
and
that makes
people
sense.
From the organization, right. can come and get trained and then go back out and carry that information back to their organization.
Okay, so is that what's happening today? Is
yeah.
it training? Maybe that's what I got. Is it?
Correct. So
okay, that's
there
what's
will
in
be
my
a
brain.
One
See
hour.
There?
our meetings are typically 90 minutes, but we usually have a 1 hour segment that's informational mm-hmm. or educational. Mm-hmm. Today we're going to be doing what's called Dementia Friends. It's a 1 hour program where community members can come and learn what it means to be a dementia friend. And everybody who completes the 1 hour training gets a little pin. It's a heart pin that tells everybody that they're a dementia friend. It's just basic information to educate somebody about what dementia is and also how to respond to somebody with dementia. You know, our whole goal here is to encourage people to walk towards somebody with dementia instead of walking away. In other words, by understanding just a little bit about what they're going through, it may ease that initial apprehension to okay. want to help them.
So what's the difference, share with us the difference between dementia and Alzheimer's? Are they kind of one in the same, but at a different level, or?
Okay. You want me? Yeah, go ahead.
Sure. So okay. dementia is kind of a more of an umbrella term.
Okay.
And then there's different types of dementia.
Okay.
So one type is dementia of the Alzheimer's type. You could also get a dementia because you have, say, a reduction in blood flow to your brain, things like that. So it's just one of the different types of dementia.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, now Alzheimer's tends to be the most prevalent form. About 60 to 80% of diagnosed dementias are currently Alzheimer's. That's been the trend for as long as studies have been done.
Mm-hmm.
And that's probably why you know the word Alzheimer's, because it's the most talked about. But there's actually about 80 different diagnosed varieties of dementia. And what it really comes down to,
Did you say 80?
Yes. There's about 80 diagnosed varieties. And what dementia is, it's a cognitive impairment. It's where part of your brain ceases to function correctly. It could be brought on by a stroke or a heart attack or something else that is stopping the blood flow. It could also be a natural progression of aging. And most of us, as we age, we think, oh, well, my memory is not what it used to be. Maybe I have dementia. The truth is that having your memory be slightly off as you age is what's called normal aging. And not to be mistaken with dementia. Dementia is where it's a progressive illness that could eventually put the individual in harm's way, because they won't be able to make correct decisions to keep themselves safe. And that's why it's really critical. One of the things that's been done locally here by LA County, actually, is Los Angeles County put out something called the Purposeful Aging Initiative. And several aspects, elements of it, do address dementia-friendly communities,
mm-hmm.
one of which was releasing funding for something called LA Found. All the local sheriff's departments now have the ability to deploy LA Found. It is a bracelet that can be issued to an individual that may be a wanderer. And that's one of the real dangers. Once somebody doesn't know how to get home or who they are anymore, if they wander away from a safe zone like their home,
mm-hmm.
the chance of you finding them is very limited. But with these tracking bracelets, the sheriff's department could find them. There is.
There's a chip or something.
Correct. It is a radio frequency transponder.
Okay. Okay.
And under certain circumstances, the sheriffs can turn that transponder on and find the individual. Now, Monrovia Police Department actually has similar technology, and we've been working with them as well as other first responders.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing I really want you to know about Dementia Friendly is it's a cross-sector collaborative. That means that individuals from every single sector of business and community are engaged. Like you mentioned, faith community.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely, we want to engage with the faith community. But we're also engaged with the city. That's where they proclaimed City of Monrovia Dementia Friendly on June 4th, 2019.
Mm-hmm.
We've been working with the city manager's office, with the library, with the community center, with the senior center. So we work very closely with them, but we've also been working with law enforcement, with fire department, with local businesses like restaurants and banks. Like Dr. Flynn has her own company where her company is engaged in working on technology for the neurosciences, which are obviously directly related
mm-hmm.
to brain diseases. So by encouraging individuals from every sector to come and participate, everybody has a voice, everybody has a seat at the table. So as we're developing and creating a dementia-friendly Monrovia, the community itself has been building this.
Okay. Now, when you speak of that, what actually does dementia-friendly community mean? What does that look like?
Okay. Can I give an example?
Okay. Absolutely.
I would love for you to tell the library example,
okay.
but I'll tell Chris's example,
okay.
which is, a friend that we both know, her mother had dementia, and so she wasn't able to leave her mother at home alone.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes, you know, Chris would have to go to a store and get some new clothes.
Mm-hmm.
So she would bring her mother with her, and she let the woman in the store know, my mother has dementia. She may ask you questions a few times, or she may decide to wander out the front door. would you please keep an eye on her while I go change my clothes and try on the new clothes?
Mm-hmm.
So Chris could feel comfortable about going in and not having to have her eyeballs on them on her mom. And she could change her clothes, mm-hmm. you know, try on the new clothes and then come out. And in the meantime, the person who's in the store has engaged with her mother and had a conversation and wasn't impatient, even if she knew she might have the same questions over and over mm-hmm. again. And if she was to go towards the door, she could distract her to come back inside and be safe.
Mm-hmm.
And it's educating all of our community, from bus drivers to people who maybe just walk up and down the main street of Monrovia, who go and get their exercise every morning. If they were to see someone who's just kind of looking around, like, you know, a little bit confused, like you said earlier, walk up to them and say, may I help you find something?
Mm-hmm.
Instead of thinking something's wrong with them and kind of scoot around,
yeah.
so that these people can feel, and their families can feel comfortable about having them stay a part of the community,
mm-hmm.
because social isolation is horrible for lots of reasons, including your brain and cognition.
Right.
So
it
we
is.
Want
yes.
these people to be able to stay a part of the community
mm-hmm.
as much as is safely possible. And by having us all be kind of a big team around them to make sure that they can go and come safely and you know, they're not abused, say, financially, because if someone
right.
knows they won't realize if they give them the wrong change
right.
or something along that
right.
those lines.
Right.
So by educating, you know, everyone in the community, then the family gets a little bit of confidence
mm-hmm.
that their loved one is going to be okay.
Right, right, right.
Yeah, another great example, as we were first starting to do this and we were meeting and engaging with different community leaders, I met with a group from the city, and one of the people in the group was the librarian, the head of the library,
mm-hmm.
and she mentioned that over the years that she's worked there, there was one particular individual who they were told has Alzheimer's by the family member.
Mm-hmm.
And this person happens to own a shop, or at one time owned a shop in downtown Monrovia. So when this person would go to the library to do what they were doing, as they were leaving the library, they would alert the store owner, and he would step out onto the sidewalk and watch his mom walk down to make sure that she'd safely get
mm-hmm.
from the library to his store. That is a great example of dementia friendly. There are a lot of examples of what dementia friendly looks like that we encountered initially, which told us that Monrovia was an excellent city.
It is.
To do this type of project, because the community, yeah, you
yes.
are, absolutely.
Yes.
But I think we feel the same about Monrovia that you do. It has this vibrance to it
yes.
in a sense that family and community are very important to everybody
yes.
that lives here, works here, and owns a shop here.
Right.
And we found it very easy to engage. One of the things that we're going to be rolling out very soon that Dr. Flynn touched upon is training. And some of this training we can actually bring to you. If you are a store owner,
mm-hmm.
like you have a restaurant or a shop in downtown or anywhere in Monrovia where the public actually comes in and interacts with you, and you would like your staff to be dementia friendly, we can come in and do a brief 1-hour training with you and give you those tools. And if you will do that, we'll give you a little decal that you could put on your window that says, we are dementia friendly.
Oh,
and
wow.
One other thing I want to mention is dementia friendly is actually a worldwide movement. In America, the organization that's been helping develop it is Dementia Friendly America, which we are part of. So Dementia Friendly Monrovia is one of the cities working with Dementia Friendly America. If you go to dfa.org and you do a search on Dementia Friendly Communities, the city of Monrovia is listed there.
I was going to ask mm-hmm. if there is a website or that, for instance, if somebody decides that they need to move,
right.
and so they're a parent or a relative that they're a caregiver for, that wants that one to make sure where they're moving that it's going to be safe for them.
Exactly.
And I think that's a really important thing to know. A friend of mine's mother is becoming progressively more cognitively impaired,
mm-hmm.
and when I joined this group, I said to her immediately, is your town dementia friendly? Because they're going to have resources for you. And she said, I don't even know what you're talking about. So I went on to unfortunately, they're not a town where she lives, mm-hmm. which left us both just scratching our heads, like, where do we begin? How do we even get started? What, should we, put cameras in her house so we can all keep an eye on her? I mean, mm-hmm. all these things that you just don't know how to make those first steps mm-hmm. of, how to care for people.
Right.
And it would have just been so much easier, I think, because she could have found a support group. She could have found a variety of tools if their town had been dementia friendly. So I just think it's to your point of if somebody did have to move, could they potentially go and look and see, at least my community is aware of what's happening.
Right. Or even if it's not where they're going to be moving, it could be a neighboring mm-hmm. community mm-hmm. and then they could partner up, especially, in Monrovia, Duarte, mm-hmm. Arcadia, so intertwined, in some places you walk across the street and it's Monrovia.
Right.
Or you walk, it's Duarte or it's Arcadia, mm-hmm. you see.
Right.
So,
but if you had, say, a choice for libraries, maybe you would choose
to
have your family member visit the Monrovia one because
that
group has been educated and they're aware.
Right.
Exactly. Well, yeah, they...
So excited. I'm
glad that you share our enthusiasm.
Yeah.
I think that's a big part of what it takes here to make this happen is individuals that learn about what we're doing do have this innate enthusiasm about it, and they want to share with everybody else. Our main partners that we are engaged with, that we started this with, besides Monrovia Providers Group, which I mentioned earlier on, is Alzheimer's Los Angeles.
Mm-hmm.
They serve the entire San Gabriel Valley as well as a big part of Los Angeles County. And they have hundreds of resources, including a 24-hour helpline that anybody dealing with dementia or the family member can call. So they do lend us their resources, and we want to encourage people to use them. We also have a direct partnership now with Azusa Pacific University, Dr. Adria Navarro, who teaches their MSW, their Master mm-hmm. of Social Work program,
mm-hmm.
is one of the key leaders on our committee, as well as Dr. Cheryl Flynn with Blue Marble Health. And so from Alzheimer's Los Angeles, our direct liaison is Kelly Takasu, who is the public policy manager for the organization. The four of us get together and talk very, very often. As a matter of fact, Kelly and I are involved directly nationally with Dementia Friendly America. We're actually in a Google group that communicates almost daily. So we're able to see what other cities are doing as well, so we can find things that maybe fit that would work for us.
Mm-hmm.
And so the end result is a vibrant community that wants to be dementia friendly.
We should have a sign that goes over, the banner, mm-hmm. That goes over
across the street, on the main street.
Yeah.
We might get there.
Yeah,
absolutely. Well, we are looking to do some more public events eventually. It's still a work in progress.
Yes.
So laying the foundation was probably the hardest part to get started. Now that we meet quarterly open to the community, we also meet monthly as our leadership team. And one of the key things that we were struggling with at first, but now we feel like we have that representation, are actual community members who are caregivers or individuals with dementia that are living in this community that are part of our group. And I think that's one of the most critical pieces that we desperately needed was getting those people mm-hmm. involved. One person in particular who's shown a lot of enthusiasm for our program since he got involved and actually showed up as we received the proclamation. He had three family members that all suffered from this disease,
mm-hmm.
Both of his parents and his wife, who have all since passed, but he cared for them himself and learned a lot about the disease and how to be a caregiver. So he brings a lot to our group.
Mm-hmm.
He also has an entire life of growing up and living here in the community. So we're very grateful and blessed to have people like that. We are looking for more people like that. So if somebody's watching this program and they say to themselves, well, that's me, please seek us out. If anybody wants any help or guidance or just information, we have a Facebook page, Dementia Friendly Monrovia. You can find us there. We also are going to have booklets and pamphlets that are available at the community center and at the library quite soon.
Mm-hmm.
And we're looking to start doing things like that, like bring Dementia Friends training to the library, mm-hmm. bring Dementia Friends training maybe even to the park, and just let the community come and be part of what we're doing, because
mm-hmm.
it is a community.
Yeah. We also have a survey, which I believe is still up on the Facebook page, but we tried to do a survey to get as many people from the community to tell us about themselves and what their needs are. And so that survey is still available. People could go and you know, input their information about if they want, say, particular classes, or what kind of support do they need, or who are they? What
mm-hmm.
is the demographics of the group that
mm-hmm.
Is potentially going to be served?
Mm-hmm.
So that's still available, if I'm not mistaken.
It is.
On the Facebook page.
We initially had 77 respondents to the survey, and a group of 12 students from Azusa Pacific University, all going towards their master in social work,
mm-hmm.
participated in helping us deploy and develop the study.
Mm-hmm.
And right before they graduated, actually gave us the preliminary results. They've all since graduated with their master's degree. And now there's a new class is going to be coming in the fall, and we're going to be working with them. And those are all Dr. Navarro's students. So we're excited about how this is developing. I mean, for all of this to happen just within a year is exciting.
Wow.
You know, I mean, it takes a village,
they
say. And I think we definitely found the right village.
Well, you know, tell me, I have this other question. excuse me. Is there an age limit on, you said you're having these training classes.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, workshops or whatever, because, you know, just like you said, it affects the whole family.
Correct.
So, you know, our little ones need to know, and I'll give you an example. I'm a member of the Baha'i Faith, and once a month we have what we call pancakes and prayers. And one of our friends from the Baha'is in Claremont came, and he was kind of, we wasn't sure because his wife has Alzheimer's.
Mm-hmm.
And I was so happy to meet her, and her eyes just lit up because my nieces were here from the little ones that they were here from Kansas. They're 7.5 and 5. And her face, you know, from her walking in the door, you know, she kind of smiled, but it was like the light bulb went off when she saw the kids. Her eyes just glistened, and she had a really big smile on her face.
Sure.
And so he shared, he goes, she didn't talk much. He was telling her what to say. And he then shared with us that she really loves children, that she
mm-hmm.
just kept smiling and everything. And I was so proud of my nieces and nephews, how they treated her. And it wasn't any, you know, because little kids, you know, I'm a former kindergarten teacher.
Mm-hmm.
And so whenever, like when we would go to senior homes, assisted living homes especially, I always prepare the kids because I don't want them to get afraid or you know, you just don't know what goes on in their brain.
Sure.
Usually what goes on there comes out here.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes.
What? Yes. So I always prepare them. And so it was so important that it was just the utmost respect. And they looked at it, they knew something was a little bit different, but they were so kind, you know, from the 5-year-old all the way up to the 22-year-old.
Yes.
So that's why it is, that just, because she's a grandmother, you know, she has grandchildren.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Well, I could definitely see us developing something that's a little family friendly and geared towards that eventually. Mm-hmm. Right now, the trainings we have are really for people that, well, you know, 18 and over, I would say. Mm-hmm. Not that there's anything that, say, a 16-year-old couldn't learn.
Right.
It's just they may not be able to attend some of the program that we're doing, or maybe they don't have that direct experience with an individual.
Right.
But
right.
It's open to anybody who would like. And if a parent did come, I mean, we wouldn't turn them away.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Not at all. You know, once again, this is really still in its development phase. We're really in our infancy as far as what our capabilities are. We definitely want to hear from more community members that have an interest in what we're doing. And I think the as we grow and develop, you're going to start seeing and hearing about different programs and things that we're doing in the community. And don't forget, as you do walk through the shops and stores in Monrovia, say over the next year, look for our little decals. Look for that decal.
And what's
that says,
the decal again?
Well, it's still in progress.
Oh, okay.
It's a little sticker.
Okay.
That's gonna say we are dementia friendly.
Oh, okay.
And it'll
okay.
have our little icon and stuff. And
okay.
We're still working on the artwork.
Okay.
But
the important thing is it says dementia friendly.
That's right. That is the key thing you will be seeing in and around the community, and finally, I would say, you know, we're very grateful for the opportunity to be of service to this community, because that's really what this is. This mm-hmm. is a labor of love mm-hmm. by everybody that's involved.
Right. Well, our time is coming to an end. So any last minute things that you want to say before we say?
Okay.
Yes.
Go for it.
Okay.
So I just want everybody to know that they can contact me directly. I am a manager at Senior Helpers in Arcadia, 140 East Foothill Boulevard in Arcadia. You can reach me directly. My phone number is 626-536-7928. If you or a family member need some assistance or want some direction as to what to do, please call me or seek me out on Facebook or our website, and I'd be happy to be of service.
Thank you. You know, I gave your number to. I don't know if they called to be. Remember, I shared with you that someone in
you
Alhambra.
Did. Yes.
And so I don't know if they.
I was contacted.
Oh, you were.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Did you have a final?
I think the main message that I would get across is just we really want to be responsive to the community. So if you reach out on the Facebook page or give Nathan a call, that's going to direct us as to how we are going to work for this community.
Yeah, yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, thank you both for being on the show. I am so excited. The banner's gonna go across.
All right, we will get there.
Street banner.
I love your enthusiasm.
Yes.
So again, thank you for watching, and go out and be a blessing to someone, and we'll see you next time. Bye.
Hello, I'm Supervisor Catherine Barger. Good news, with greater access to quality health care, Americans are living longer and healthier lives. Our older American communities are growing each year. In fact, the percentage of older adults in Los Angeles County is expected to double by 2030. To address the needs of our aging population, the county launched the Purposeful Aging Initiative to ensure our communities and agencies are meaningfully engaged to support our residents as they grow older. Support means helping them successfully address tough obstacles like Alzheimer's and other forms of dementia. That is why I'm proud to highlight the Dementia Friends program. In partnership with Alzheimer's Greater Los Angeles, Dementia Friends offers insight into this condition and training to help you provide support for someone in need. I'm proud to be a dementia friend and wear this heart pin so that people know that I understand and I'm here to help. I hope you will join me and others supporting individuals and families facing dementia in our communities. Go online to learn more and take the training. Help us turn understanding into action. Thank you.
As members of a community, it can be easy, sometimes, for us to spot someone in need. But when it comes to people with dementia, the signs are not always so obvious. Without the support of the community, families and individuals affected by dementia can often feel invisible, lost, and in some cases, in danger. Everyone has a role in creating a safe and supportive dementia-friendly community. Your community can take steps to become dementia-friendly by following a four-phase process. In Action Phase 1, you'll bring people together from all areas of the community, from government to healthcare, local businesses, and faith groups. Everyone from young to old should be invited, especially people living with dementia and their family and friend care partners. In Action Phase 2, your community will assess your current strengths and gaps when it comes to meeting the needs of people living with dementia. Then you'll share information with community members so they understand and have resources for adopting practices and policies that will make it easier for people with dementia to carry out their everyday activities, like banking and shopping. In Action Phase 3, you'll prioritize what your community can do to become more dementia-friendly. Finally, in Action Phase 4, your community will act together, taking steps to become dementia-friendly and improving the quality of life for everyone touched by the disease. Ideally, all areas of the community adopt dementia-friendly practices, and the entire community undertakes goals they have chosen together. You can become part of a growing movement in creating dementia-friendly communities. By taking small steps together, we can make a real difference.
It is not a failing of character. It is not a weakness. It is a disease. And so we must disentangle this notion that dementia is a natural part of the aging process or that it's something to be ashamed of.
I was ignorant about the disease when I was diagnosed, and so I had to get in and learn. And I didn't want other people to be ignorant either. My whole focus has been trying to educate, advocate, and help bring awareness to the disease.
A dementia-friendly community is a community in which every sector of community steps up and does its unique part in making sure that those who are living with dementia in community can continue to access community services and support.
Dementia-friendly is a state of mind. It's a state of being. It's educating others that you can be inclusive. All of your family members can be at the table, including the person that has dementia. They do not have to be excluded.
It's my hope that through Dementia Friendly America, that people will walk towards people with dementia and see how they can ensure that they are part of the community rather than walking away and making them feel isolated.
The best way for an individual to get active in the dementia-friendly movement is actually to go to dfamerica.org, where you can go online, get a basic education about what dementia is and how to respond to people with dementia, and participate simply as a member of a community in helping the community become more dementia-friendly.
What a world of difference that would make in the daily lives of people with dementia, caregivers, tourists, and anyone else in that community. No judgments, no preconceived notions, no fear, no resentment, no pause, just help.